In 1980, the Secretary of Defense Harold Brown gathered reporters at the Pentagon and announced to the world the existence of a new technology called stealth. Sure, stealth had always existed since the age of ninjas, but for aviation, it was never even a blip on the radar. Yeah, the jokes are just going downhill from here. The fighters of World War II could be heard by troops on the ground from miles away, and by the end of the war, even the preliminary radar technology of the day could detect approaching enemy aircraft from across the English Channel. By the 1960s, radar technology had improved to the point that an aircraft could be detected from 2,500 kilometers away. Going into the Cold War, the ability to hide from detection was becoming more and more important, but trying to hide aircraft from detection wasn't a new problem. In fact, it existed long before radar. Back in World War I, the Germans experimented with the use of Celon, a transparent covered material, in an attempt to reduce the visibility of military aircraft. Unfortunately for those early pilots, it turned out that sunlight bouncing off the covering made the aircraft even more visible to forces on the ground. Nearly three decades later, the Germans in World War II accidentally stumbled onto a radar-resistant plane with the Horten Ho 229. Without the vertical surfaces common in the planes of the era, the plane proved to be nearly undetectable to the radar technology of the time. And Americans studying how to avoid radar came up with a similar design, the YB-49 Flying Wing. The all-wing configuration generated a relatively small image on radar screens. But for the World Wars, these planes were just ahead of their time, and radar just wasn't enough of a concern, and so plans for the YB-49 were scrapped. The 60s saw the rollout of the A-12, a plane that nearly 60 years after its first flight remains the fastest air-breathing jet to ever fly. But it was the SR-71 Blackbird, a variant developed for the Air Force that would go on to serve for decades and become one of the most widely recognized planes in history. The Blackbird could cruise at Mach 3.2, right near the edge of space, and could do it for hours on end. Its unusual shape helped reduce its radar signature, but it was really its special black paint that helped hide it from enemy radar and earn the Blackbird its name. Although, its moderate stealth capabilities didn't matter all that much, given that it could outrun the fastest anti-air missiles on the planet. In their deployments over Korea and Vietnam in the 60s and 70s, they'd be unsuccessfully targeted by over 800 surface-to-air missiles. In fact, in its 30-year operational history, no SR-71 was ever shot down. But the SR-71 was just like the planes of World War I wrapped in Celon. The planes were built, and then stealth characteristics like its radar-absorbent paint were added as an afterthought. But the Air Force got to thinking, what if a plane was built with stealth in mind from the start? Well, meet the F-117 Nighthawk. The F-117 was designed with the rudimentary computers of the 70s. Because of limited computational power, the 117 could only be modeled using straight edges, unlike the curved surfaces of stealth aircraft we see today. The design was so successful that the plane's 13-meter wingspan would show up the same as a pigeon on radar. This meant that the F-117 was able to get more than 90% closer to radar stations before being detected. Be sure to watch our video on the Gulf War if you want to learn more about the F-117's impressive technology. 1982 saw the introduction of probably the strangest and least known stealth aircraft, Tactic Blue. Despite its weird shape, Tactic Blue was the first attempt at using curved structures on a stealth aircraft. Although Tactic Blue never saw action in combat, its developments would be applied directly to the B-2 stealth bomber that would be used for penetrating anti-aircraft defenses. The B-2 would become the world's most expensive plane, with each of the 21 units produced costing $2.1 billion. The 2000s saw the rollout of the F-22 and F-35. The F-22's vertical fins, unlike the prior F-15s, were angled outward to deflect radar, and horizontal fins at the back of the plane shielded engine exhaust from detection. And unlike former fighters like the F-15 and F-16 that could only carry missiles under the wings, where they were one of the greatest contributing factors to radar detection, the F-22 could carry weaponry in internal weapons bays to maintain its stealth signature. Exact details about the F-22's coating obviously remain classified, but we know it's specially designed to absorb radar waves. And even the cockpit shape was designed to minimize radar bouncing off of the pilot's reflective helmet. And in recent years, countries like Russia and China have stepped into the stealth game, with planes modeled largely after American ones, and even thought to be based on stolen classified designs. And all that brings us to today, the history of stealth aircraft in under 5 minutes. Let us know what other topics you want to see explained in under 5 minutes down in the comments. And remember, there's always more to learn.